Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Dear brothers, sisters and viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome to our regular live webinar in this blessed month of Ramadan. Tonight we have a beautiful guest, alhamdulillah, our Shaykh al-Kabir, Fazilat al-Shaykh, Shaykh Moustafa Hassan. He is not only Shaykh, she is a good reciter. Alhamdulillah, Sautan Jameel. Qari Sheikh Moustafa Hassan, we would say. His topic will be Qur'an, the word of Allah. Allahu Akbar. First, we'll listen some recitation from him. Then he will give a short talk, inshallah. Faddal Sheikh, Sheikhana, Faddal.
Jazakallah khair, Sheikh Rafiq. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد اتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون والله الذي لا هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين صدق الله العظيم الفاتحة
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين صراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم آمين
ما شاء الله very beautiful recitation الله
بارك جزاك الله خير أخي الشيخ رفيق بارك الله فيك
تفضل شيخ
بارك الله فيك الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين اللهم إنا نحمدك حمدا يليق بجلال وجهك العظيم وسلطانك القديم فأنت أهل الحمد والثناء ولا نحصي ثناء عليك ربنا أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك يا رب العالمين My dear brothers and sisters, it's a pleasure to be with you tonight. And I thank my dear brother, Sheikh Fadil Sheikh Maulana Rafiq al-Islam, Barakallah fi, for inviting me for this night with you. Jazakumullah khairan. So inshallah, I will be talking about the topic as you got know from Sheikh Rafiq. The Qur'an is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before I start, just I would like to inform you that I have a very low level of English, so please, inshallah, يعني forgive me for this and try to understand, inshallah, my English as it is. بارك الله فيكم. جزاكم الله خير. So as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the verse that, one of the verses that I recited, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, after أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون ولا تكونوا أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب الجنة أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل, here this is the verse that I'd like to talk about. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, لو أنزلنا, indeed, if we reveal the Qur'an onto the mountain, or if we reveal the Qur'an to one of the mountain will destroy. لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِعًا مُتَصَدِّعًا مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. So from the fairness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mountain will get fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and it will destroy. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the words of him, the Qur'an, it's not just something to recite and say, mashallah, it's a very nice voice. So this is a dastur for us, a constitution for Muslims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without the Qur'an, will make our life miserable, or our life will be miserable. Allah will not make it miserable, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why we never feel like away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we feel away from his path subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran will return us to him, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said a very beautiful hadith. It's too long and I will try inshallah to summarize to you bi idhnillahi ta'ala. He said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib, he narrated, he said qala rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam satakunu fitanun ka qit'i al-layl al-mudhlim. It will be a time of darkness, and each problem, it will be like a certain, subhanallah, and difficult dark area or dark environment itself. And then Sayyidina Imam Ali said, I asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I said, وَمَا الْمَخْرَجُ مِنْهَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, how that we can avoid it. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kitab Allah, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he starts, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to describe the Qur'an and the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, فِيهِ خَبَرُوا مَنْ قَبْلَكُمْ, it has a story of people before you to learn from them. He didn't say to get learned, but this what he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فِيهِ خَبَرُوا مَنْ قَبْلَكُمْ, it has the stories of people before you. وَفِيهِ نَبَأُ مَنْ بَعْدَكُمْ, and has the news for the people will come after you, which is Allah telling us about people will come after. As he mentioned subhanahu wa ta'ala about the akhiru zaman, as he mentioned subhanahu wa ta'ala about the hereafter, as he mentioned subhanahu wa ta'ala about some kind of people, what they will do. And all this, this is the news of people will come up after our time, or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's time. هو الفصل ليس بالهزل. And this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he describes the Qur'an, or described the Qur'an sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to teach us in general that the Qur'an, this is the thing, the only thing, it can protect us from the fitness. And when I say fitness, because we have a lot of fitness, not only one or two, we have a lot of fitness. And the only thing will protect us, inshallah, this is the Qur'an, the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why even Imam Abu Hanifa radiallahu anhu arda, he said when he was about to die rahmatullahi alayhi, he said whatever fatwa that I gave to you, you have to يعني, compare between it and the Quran and Sunnah. If you see my fatwa is wrong, it's not compromised and it's not matching with the Quran and Sunnah, so ignore it, just to protect himself, to show us how is the Quran and the Sunnah, and especially the Quran is very important. And subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, and that's why we believe, that's why this is the biggest evidence for us as Muslims that we are in the right religion, alhamdulillah, and we are in the right path. And Allah subhanahu, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. We are indeed, we send the dhikr, which is the Quran, and we will protect it. And that's why, alhamdulillah, if you open any mushaf, in Australia here, or in Mecca, in Egypt, in Bangladesh, in Sri Lanka, in America, and in anywhere. When you open it, the first page, it will be the same, and up to the last page, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected. We think the Quran, it comes like us like this. No. Subhanallah, the Quran, it has too many times and too many challenges. People who hate Islam, they try to change some of it. Even in the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and recently after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the time after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam directly, they start to put sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave dhikr to Prophet Muhammad, they think people, because of they love Prophet Muhammad, they will start saying whatever, like for example, Taha sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he held, or he used, if we can use this as a bitter word, he used subhanahu wa ta'ala, sahaba, the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the tabi'een who came before them, to protect the Quran for us. So the Quran, as we have it now in the Mus'haf, in the Quran book, it doesn't come easy for us. Wallahi, it comes with a very hard, in a very hard time, when Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu ardaan, with the opinion of Sayyidina Umar, they start to collect the Quran in one book. And subhanAllah, too many stories about Quran, too many things about Quran. But the most important thing, and the thing that inshallah I will conclude inshallah my speech with, that why we love to read the Quran during the Ramadan time more than any other time. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, after a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, he says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran. So Shahru Ramadan, this is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran, and he sent the Quran down to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some people, they ask, did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the Quran only in Ramadan? Actually not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Quran to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in different times. So in each issue happened with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to send some Quran to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to correct something to him, or to order to him, or whatever. So the Quran came down in Ramadan, in Shawwal, in Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hijjah, Al-Muharram, and all the months, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to send the Quran. But why Allah said subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah, Shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fi al-Quran, as the Quran, in total Quran has been revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Ramadan. Yes, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and he explained why Allah said that. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Jibreel alayhi salam, he used to recite the whole Quran to me in each Ramadan. But this Ramadan, which is, it was the last Ramadan of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's time, he said, but this Ramadan, Jibreel alayhi salam, arad alayya al-Quran marratayn. So Jibreel, he recited the Quran to me two times, which is Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he understood that his time is over. He's about to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his life is end. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he loves to hear from us recite the Quran in Ramadan more. And the second thing, why we recite the Quran in Ramadan more than any other time, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave us a very, very special times. Not only in Ramadan, in the first 10 days of the Hijjah, and subhanAllah, the night of Al-Qadr, and Yawm al-Jumu'az, the Fridays, and subhanAllah, the hour before, between Al-Asr and Al-Maghrib, in each Friday. And subhanAllah, that's why Prophet ﷺ said, أَلَا إِنَّ فِي أَيَّامِ دَهْرِكُمْ لَنَفَحَاتٍ أَلَا فَتَعَرَّضُوا لَهَا. He said, you have a very special times in your life, so take care of it and use it in a good way. That's why in Ramadan, because Ramadan is a very special month to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiply our ibadah in Ramadan to him more than what he give. He reward us subhanahu wa ta'ala more than what he reward us in the time, not in Ramadan, like before Ramadan or after Ramadan. That's why when we recite the Quran, so I'll give you an example. If we recite the Quran, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من قرأ القرآن فله بكل حرف حسن. So whoever will recite the Quran, he will get for each letter, he will get one good deed. والحسنة بعشر أمثالها, and Allah will multiply it for 10. والله يضاعف لمن يشاء. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, and Allah will multiply it more to whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes to do for him. So if we get, for example, like 10 good deeds in Shawwal, in Rajab, or in Shawwal, or in Zilqa'dah, or Jamadi al-Ula, or any month of the Islamic calendar, or 80 days instead of Ramadan, if Allah give us 10 good deeds for each letter, so you have to think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you like 100 in Ramadan. That's why we love to recite the Quran in Ramadan, to recite the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second thing, or actually the third thing, and this is in general, not just in Ramadan, this in general, we love the Quran because sometimes we forgot like, this is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said himself, this Quran, and he said, Ya Jibreel, go and give this Quran to Muhammad. Oh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he ordered to the angels in the Lawh al-Mahfuz, in the book in the sky, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered to them to write this, and Jibreel alayhi salam, he take it from the Lawh al-Mahfuz. And then he came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then he recited to Prophet Muhammad, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he recited to his companions, they recited to the tabi'een, and generation by generation, until we got the Quran. That's why when we got the ijaza, it says to me, Mustafa Hassan, he recited on me, Sheikh Fulan, from Sheikh Fulan, from Imam Fulan, from Imam Muhammad, from Imam, until from Imam Sayyidina Ubay ibn Ka'b, from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from Jibreel, from Lawh al-Mahfuz, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how we took the ijaza of the qira'at, subhanallah. So imagine when you realize that you are in chin, you are one of it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the end of it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the words for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How pleasure is it, subhanallah, it is. And subhanallah, you feel special with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I said to you that the last thing, but يعني, sorry, I'm taking more time. So it will be, inshallah, the last thing, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, to remind you about the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he said, الذي يقرأ القرآن وهو عليه شاق. So the one who recites the Quran and it's very difficult for him, له أجران. He will be rewarded twice from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One because he recites the Quran, and one reward because he struggled with it. So the Sahaba, they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they said, Ya Rasulullah, if the one who feels struggling with the Quran, he will get double rewards. What about al-mahara, al-mahiru bil-Quran, the one who excellent in the Quran? And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, هَؤُلَاءِ مَعَ السَّفَرَةِ الْكِرَامِ الْبَرَرَةِ. Those people will be with in the day of judgment with the Safar al-Kiram al-Barar, with the angels, not only any angels, with the very special angels to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the names of the angels, Safara, wa Kiram, wa Barara. So the three describes of the angels, the very special and very high level angels. And subhanallah, those people, or the Qurra of Quran, they will be with them. And subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him about the Qurra, about the one who recited the Quran and memorized the Quran and always recited, and Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ غَرَسْتُ كَرَامَتَهُمْ بِيَدِي. Those people, the people that I made the dignity by my own hand. Imagine when you recite the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you recite something that Allah mentioned it, Allah say it himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala, how lucky we are, wallahi al-azim. And if we have no place from blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but just be a Muslim and recite the Quran, it will be enough to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and appreciate this blessing from him. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us, inshallah, from the people of Quran, from the people of Quran, inshallah, and from people who memorize the Quran. And subhanallah, imagine when one of the ulama, I think Imam al-Hasan al-Basri, one of the ulama, I forgot the name, he said to his son, revise the Quran each day at least 5 juz's. And he said, we have the ceremony and the day of judgment, a special ceremony for the Qurra, for the people who memorize the Quran. Allah will say to them, and the presents for them, Allah will say to them, Iqra wartaqi, read and go up. So for each verse, for each ayah that you will recite in the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise you one darajah up, one level up. And the Prophet ﷺ said, between the living and the level, as it between the earth and the heaven and the sky. Subhanallah. And this is the words of the people who loves the Quran, people who recite the Quran, people who recite the Quran. Some of you will ask, Sheikh, طيب, what about if it's very hard for me to recite it? If it's very hard for me, I got old and I cannot memorize it. Even those people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after he takes everyone from everyone who was memorizing the Quran, he will say subhanahu wa ta'ala, Aina al-Nuddar? Aina al-Nuddar? Al-Nuddar, which is the people who used to look. And they will say, which Nuddar, ya Allah? He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, people who used to, those people cannot memorize the Quran, but they usually used to look at the Quran, the Mus'haf, and read from it. And even those people will be, inshallah, in the very high level in Al-Jannah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us, inshallah, amongst the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, people who will be saved in the day of judgment, will be under his throne subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the shadow and for his throne subhanahu wa ta'ala, and will be saved and will be in Al-Jannah with our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I thank you for listening. Jazakumullah khair for everyone, especially Akhi Fadilat Sheikh Rafiq al-Islam. Jazakumullah khair. The microphone
will be. Ameen, ameen, ya Rabbul Alameen. Jazakumullah khair, Sheikh, for your time, beautiful recitation, and wonderful nasiha about Quran. May Allah accept all of us among those who are Ahlul Quran. Ameen, ya Rabbul Alameen. Sheikh, Jazakallah for your busy time you have given this time. It is a great pleasure for
us. Allah Ya'azzak, Habibi, Barakallah. And I'd like, wallahi, to stay with you, but after less than 1 hour, I have the Quran recitation with the Sheikh Ala, so it will be online as well. So I have to, inshallah, pray al-Isha before I meet him, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. So if you please excuse me, inshallah, and allow me to go.
Inshallah, we have question, but I am not asking any question.
No, you can ask. I have like, inshallah, 5 minutes, bi'idhnillah, 5 to 15 minutes, inshallah, if you like. Fadda, Habib.
And one question that I'd like to ask, because one brother is waiting for this question probably. And also this question you already mentioned in your last part of your talk. The questions regarding Assalamu Alaikum Sheikh is, my question is, do you need to learn or to recite Quran, improving the Quran, or just to know the meaning and practice the ayah? That means improving recitation or need to meaning and practice the ayah? Which one is priority?
Barakallah feek, barakallah feek. Look, Akhi, for this question, you know, we have our scholars, they said, we have, it's fardu ayn for each Muslim to learn ulum sharia. So to learn about the Islam, Quran, tafsir, sunnah, hadith, I mean, seerah, all the sharia knowledge. They said this is fard ayn. For each one who cannot get it and he didn't put effort, Allah will ask him. It's not, he will not be free. He will not be free at all. We have to say this in general, especially for the Quran. And subhanAllah, we have a very beautiful story. It may explain more to the brother. One of the grandchildren, he asked his grandfather and he said, why do we recite the Quran if we don't understand the meaning? And he said, okay, take this basket I will answer your question after you help, when you help me. So he gave him a basket. This basket was very dirty. And he said, go to the sea, which is the sea was next to them. And he said, fill this of water and bring it to me. So he went, he filled it with water. And but when he came to his grandfather, basket was full. Sorry, it was empty. And then he said to him, please go and try again. So 2, 3, 4 times. And then he said, grandfather, I cannot, the water cannot stay here because it has a lot of holes. This basket has a lot of holes. And he said, look at the basket. And he said, yes, basket becomes more clean. And this, he said to him, this is what how the Quran does to our hearts. Even if you cannot understand the meaning of the Quran, it's actually, you have to understand the meaning of the Quran. But if even if you cannot, the most important thing to recite it, because the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give to you, to the reward when you recite the Quran. What do we need if, from our life now? We need to collect a certain amount of good deeds to be saved in the day of judgment. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put the balance for us. So the right hand here, this is my right hand, you'll see at my left, but this is my right hand. So the right hand here, if like, if good deeds more, will be saved, will be in al-Jannah. And then, if la qadr Allah, our bad deeds more, that means we'll go to the hellfire unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive for us. So we need to collect. So the collection of the good deeds from the Quran, around the Quran, that when we recited, you will get more good deeds, more special reward when you memorize. So the we can put this as levels. First level, to memorize the Quran. Second level, to memorize some and to get know how to read proper reading. And then the third level, to read, even if you struggle with this. And at least we have to memorize some surahs, short surahs to pray, to use when we pray. And the last level, to when you read the Quran with a very low level, like as if you didn't get to learn when you was young, and now it's hard for you to memorize it, or actually to read even. But to read the Quran in Arabic, yes, you have to. You have to, and it's no excuse. Look, Akhi, and I'd like to be honest. I don't like to make it nice with people. We have to be nice. But what I mean here, we do a lot of efforts, Sheikh Rafiq, to get job. We improve our English to get a kind of job here, to increase our income, to get a better house, better car, better. What about castles in the Jannah? What about better life in the Jannah? What about better levels in the Jannah? Why we always think about the dunya and we don't think about the akhirah? So no. Allah says, Subhanahu wa Taala, "Hal yastawi?" Is this a same between the one who learned and studied and the one who didn't, who just get relaxed? No, Allah says, Subhanahu wa Taala, no, it will not be same in the day of judgment. So you have to choose, Akhi. So the brother, my dear brother, who asked, you have to choose for yourself. If you want to be with the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, as we explained, with the special angels and the prophets, and you have to memorize the Quran. If you are humble and you like to just to enter the Jannah next to the gate of the Jannah, it's up to you. But as much as you need to get a reward, and I mean, you want to get blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from in the Jannah, as much as you have to do effort and make efforts. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. I hope inshallah that you got my answer. Bi'idhnillahi ta'ala kurati.
Jazakallah khair, beautiful answer. And the brother, I think those who asked the question, we got the reply, inshallah. So Jazakallah Sheikh, we are concluding our tonight's webinar now. Barakallah fiqh Sheikh, inshallah. Next time we will listen a beautiful verse recitation. And
from Jazakallah khair, Sheikh Rafiq.
Brothers and sisters and viewers, we are concluding our tonight's webinar here. Stay safe, stay healthy, and stay home. Barakallahu lana wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa alaikum assalam.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. By the grace of Almighty Allah, we hope you are well and not affected by the current situation. This year, the blessed month of Ramadan came to us in an unprecedented circumstance when the entire world is shaken with a tiny little virus. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, every soul will test death, and we test you with evil and with good as trial, and to us you will be returned. This is the very time for us to increase our reliance on Almighty Allah. This is the very time when we need to submit to our Allah and beg His mercy. When we need the prayers the most, the prayer place Golden Wattle Masjid had to be closed to maintain physical distancing. However, despite the current grave situation, the Masjid with its various programs online is trying to keep us all connected and perform essential religious activities. Golden Wattle Masjid is delivering multiple sessions online with renowned Islamic scholars. Al Tadhkira Institute is also running online courses with separate classes for children, youths, adults, men and women.
Dear brothers and sisters, our projects are heavily relied on your contributions, particularly on the congregation of Friday prayer collections. Due to the current shutdown, there are no congregations. We need your urgent support to run the ongoing cost of these projects. This Ramadan is a wonderful opportunity for all of us to give sadaqah and get multiple rewards. As Prophet ﷺ says, the best sadaqah is the one which is given in the month of Ramadan. Please donate generously.
This Ramadan must be treated as a lifetime opportunity, since we don't know if we will get another chance to see it again. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, open your heart and contribute as much as you can in this Ramadan. Our bank details: Golden Wattle Masjid, BSB 083961, account 166573589. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-barasi wal-jununi wal-juzami wa min sayyil asqam.